Hello everyone, today I want to show you how to create a road onto a sloped surface. Generally, creating a road onto a flat surface is very easy. You can just do that by a simple slab or a simple mesh from the floor plan, and you can just fulfill it inside in your site plan. But when it comes to creating a road onto a sloped surface like this, it's a little tricky, because you need to adjust your road elevation according to your surface. But if you look at from this direction, you will see this slope is very intense. As you remember, I have created a couple of tutorials about creating a road onto a sloped surface, but that method is a bit old. It's very easy matching your road elevations, road levels with this sloped surface, but that's not true, because in the end you will get your road with a sloped angle like this. And if you look at your around on the real roads, you won't see like that. The roads will be flat from the horizontal direction. Alright, let's start the tutorial. But before that, if you are serious about learning Archicad, I suggest you to go to my Patreon page. With that page, you will see some advanced Archicad tutorials, and also you can reach all of my project files as well as this one and other bonus Archicad libraries. Alright, without any further ado, let's start the tutorial. Now at the first, I'm going to show you the classical method. We are just going to create our sloped road on this sloped surface. Let's go to floor plan. And as you can see, we have this sloped surface and we have these unwanted lines. Well, it's going to be very hard with working this, so in order to hide this lines, we will go to the settings from the Control plus T, and from here we will see this show all ridges. Let's change this with show user defined ridges, and after that I want to get rid of this cover fills, and you will see this is way more better. And also in the 3D window, you will see these all ridges are smooth. By default it's like this, but in the end you may want to use this old ridges smooth. After doing that, we will create our road. Generally, a road something like this on this surface won't be like this, because you know roads must follow the terrain, but it must follow the terrain parallel, not horizontal, perpendicular like this. So this road direction is not correct. Correct method is, where's my spline? Here. The correct way will be like this. Your road must follow your terrain slope. So let's presume that this is going to be our road and the width is going to be around 8 meters. So to do that, we will just offset this with 8 meters. You can do that from here by clicking offset all ridges, edges, and I'm just going to input here 800, and this part will be our road. So after this stage, we will create a slab or mesh. It's up to you. I'm just going to hit alt, click this mesh, because I want to create a mesh as a road, and after that I will hit space and fill inside. After that, if we click this, you will see this mesh, and also in the 3D window. Let's change this material from here, surface. Let's activate all of them and let's make this maybe asphalt light. And I want to change its height, and you will see adjusting this road is not very easy, because we will see some level difference from here. But if we change the elevation of level of the road like this, you will see the road is under the terrain. So the easiest method is, we will just intersect the road with the terrain. To do that, we will select the road first, and this is going to be as operator, as target. We are in the solid element operations. To open it, you will just right click by clicking empty space and connect solid element operations. After that, this is going to be target, and this mesh will be operator. After that, we will select this intersection, hit execute. You will see our road is now perfectly matched with the terrain. By the way, I want to change the road position in order to service our tutorial. It's going to be better around here. And as you can see in the 3D window, it was already updated. Maybe to here. Let's change the thickness. All right. Now, let's presume that our road is this, but we have some flickering problem. In order to get rid of that, we will select this road as operator. And after that, this mesh will be target, and we will use this upward extrusion. Now it's way more cleaner. Well, you may think this tutorial was already done. You can use this road because it's clear and we have a road and we don't need to adjust the road after this stage. But as I mentioned in the beginning of the tutorial, this is not correct because you will see this road is sloped, but with the wrong direction. You won't see a road something like this with horizontal direction angle. So, how can we fix this? I will show you a very good trick. Here is the very niche tip. If you select your mesh, after selecting your mesh, you can directly select your isohips lines. Like this. Or like this. You can move them in the 3D. You can even rotate them. You can change their elevation. So we will use this niche tip. How we are going to achieve? We will create different isohips lines, or we can just use our previously used line for creating the road. And after that, we are going to create additional isohips lines into this mesh. First, we click this mesh. After that, we will select mesh 2 from here, and we will hit space. Click the spline, and this is going to be fit to user ridges. User ridges means our spline, and this is our first level, and we will create the second level after that. Hit space, click the spline. Once we achieve this, you can delete this or leave as is. And now we will change that isohips lines in this 3D window. Let's select our mesh first, and after that we can select this isohips lines directly. Once we click first, then we will use the move command from here, drag in the Z axis, and I hit the shift. After that, I will click this point or this point or this point. As you can see, my road is almost perfect and not sloped with the road slope, and the cars can use this road very easily. This part is correct, but we have a very slight level difference. So to fix that, or you can just leave it as this. It's up to you. Or if you want to create a complete road on this surface, you will go back to the floor plan and let's say that we will change this elevation with this set, and as you can see it's 94. Let's make this 95. The key point is to change this value, and after that we will use this apply to all as 95. After that we will do the same for this spline. Click one of this, it doesn't matter which one you click, and after that we will input the same height. And now this is the completely flat road where you can see in the real world, and this is how you can do that in the Archicad. I hope you have enjoyed with this tutorial, and I hope you have learned something new. If you have any questions or suggestions, if you know way more better method for this kind of problem, please leave your comments in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye. And if you are serious about learning Archicad, you can go to my Patreon page. From there, I will be waiting for you. Alright, thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye.